Salvador Dali had an on-again, off-again relationship with the Catholic Church, and his religious upbringing affected so much of his entire career. His mother was a devout Catholic and his father was an atheist. So right from the beginning of his life, there was a certain amount of tumult as it came to religion. As Dali was a part of the Surrealist movement, they really rejected Catholicism in the Catholic Church in the 1920s, so he did move away from religion for quite some time. Yet you consistently see it through his artworks. Some of Dali's most recognized religious works are the Ecumenical Council, Sacrament of the Last Supper, Cristo de San Juan de la Cruz, Christ of St. John of the Cross, and the Crucifixion, Corpus Hypercubus. Specifically, I'd like to cover Dali's work, Cristo de San Juan de la Cruz, Christ of St. John of the Cross. Dali originally painted Cristo de San Juan de la Cruz in 1951, and it's a depiction of the Christ figure taken in a very unusual angle, kind of from above, where the Christ figure is looking down. You are not seeing any sort of marks or nails, and that was very intentional. The Christ figure is levitating over a bay, and that is in Port Llobregat, where Dali had a home and spent a lot of time. Personally, this is one of my favorite depictions of Christ in a painting, mainly because it has such an unusual perspective. Not everybody feels the same way about that, but nobody can deny that it is one of the most impactful religious works of the 20th century. In the 1500s in Spain, John of the Cross was a very significant person in the church. He was a priest, he was a mystic, and he was later canonized as a saint. Christ of St. John on the Cross by Salvador Dali is actually based on a drawing done by the priest in the 1500s. Dali did many unusual depictions of Christ. In some instances, Christ appears to be levitating. In other instances, there actually is no cross. The sculpture Christ of St. John of the Cross is one of Dali's most significant religious works. It was originally created out of wax in 1973, and is part of the Clot collection. What's interesting once again about this sculpture is that it's a different depiction of Christ. Just like as in some of Dali's paintings where the Christ figure is at a different angle or there are no nails, this work actually doesn't even have a cross. We're not really seeing a face of any sort, and the Christ figure almost levitates as there's no cross that's keeping it to the ground. It's actually just a nail that's embedded into rocks. So there's a certain lightness and mysticism to this work. Later in life, Dali did end up returning to the church, and you see a combination of religious iconography and science in a lot of his works, which is kind of unusual, but that's what makes his work so compelling. Most depictions of Christ show a tattered man that is covered in bruises and scrapes and blood, but that is not the case with a lot of the works that Dali did. The reason for this is because Dali felt that it was this kind of ethereal mysticism that Christ really encapsulated. We hope you enjoyed learning a little bit about Salvador Dali and his religious upbringing and some of his most important works, specifically Christ of St. John of the Cross.
How is my hair?